Hi there, YouTubers. Thanks for coming to my author blog. I am Martin McConnell, the author of the upcoming book, Viral Spark. Today, I'm going to be talking a little bit about alien civilizations, and I want your input. I started thinking about doing this kind of topic for aliens, because aliens play a huge part in sci-fi, which, if you're coming to my author blog, you're probably interested in science fiction, seeing as how Viral Spark's a sci-fi book. But there's so many different directions to go with it that I had a tough time hammering one down. So definitely, if you've got any ideas or suggestions for upcoming videos and you want to talk more about aliens, let me know. Shoot me a comment down below or send me an email with the contact information, and I'd love to get more ideas on this, because it's really hard to nail something down that I can talk about for 5 or 10 minutes. I did come across an interesting idea this morning, and I kind of wanted to get it out there, put it out there, so it'll be a perfect video for this week. I thought, that'll be easy, and I've already done like 17 takes, and I haven't been able to nail it down quite right, but I'm going to try and get it this time. The thing I was thinking about this morning is, everybody gets caught up in looking for alien civilizations, saying, oh, there's got to be other life out there somewhere, and you know what, there probably does, but it doesn't necessarily mean it's going to be an alien civilization, or at least an advanced civilization that we can even talk to. They're probably either going to be millions of years ahead of us, and some kind of robots, or they're going to be so de-evolved from where we're sitting that they're just going to look like animals, or bacteria, or viruses. And they're not really going to have the things that we consider to be an advanced civilization. Or maybe we won't even be considered an advanced civilization to them. But I started thinking one of the biggest hurdles to forming a civilization could be found not by looking into outer space, but just looking here on planet Earth. I mean, there are 8.7 million different species that we know about on planet Earth right now, yet we're the only ones that we consider to have an advanced civilization. Now, why is this? It's obviously not intelligence, because there's plenty of intelligent animals out there. Bees are intelligent, birds are intelligent, octopuses are extremely intelligent, but I don't see them building castles underwater and attacking each other and coming up with their own philosophies and theologies, so there had to be something more. In the case of octopuses, they don't live very long after they give birth to young, and I've only seen a couple on ROV videos, but they're usually wandering around by themselves, and they tend not to huddle in groups. So obviously, in order to have an advanced civilization, number one, you have to be social, and number two, you've got to have some kind of method for passing knowledge on to your young. Because hey, if you figure out how to make a fire, and you're sitting out in the woods alone with nobody to talk to about it, then your fire idea is going to die whenever you die. You're not going to be able to pass it on to anybody else. And even if you do find a mate and have kids, if you die immediately afterwards, those kids are never going to benefit from that knowledge. It takes a lot more than intelligence to form an intelligent civilization. Your environment, of course, is going to play a role. There's going to be a certain amount of material strength that you need to construct things like high-rise towers, and radio towers, and spacefaring equipment. And in our case, spacefaring equipment requires the use of metallurgy. And you can't start learning about electricity, really, until you can harness the power of iron. And it's kind of hard to smelt iron in an underwater cavern. So an underwater civilization is probably not going to get much of a push. Even though I still believe octopuses are capable of it, if they could just come together and do their thing. But I designed an alien for one of my novels that I was working on, and this thing floats around in outer space. It didn't develop on land, but it also doesn't have any kind of civilization. It's more like a space amoeba. So there's all kinds of different routes you can go with aliens. The topics of discussion are limitless, so if there's something interesting that you want to hear my point of view on or hear me talk about, or even argue about with me, drop it in the comment section. I'm going to leave it at that. I'm going to try and keep it simple and not branch out too far. If there's other aspects of this that you want to talk about, by all means, leave a comment. And I'd be more than willing to do some more videos on aliens, because I know everybody loves aliens, right? Especially if you're into sci-fi. If you like my videos, of course you can subscribe, and Viral Spark will be coming out next month, so I'm looking forward to that. But as always, if you have a comment or a suggestion for an upcoming video, leave me a comment below. You can also stalk me. I've included all the appropriate information to find me elsewhere on the interwebs. And until next time, bye. Keep reading.